present pandemic, there is a solution in the Word of God. Now hear what the Bible says in the book of James chapter 1 verse 18. James chapter 1 verse 18. He said, of his own will begat he us with the word of truth, that we should be a kind of a first fruit of his creation. Now we are begat of his word, of his own will. So the word of God should rule us. And in times like this, we must allow the word of God gain the sense of faith in our life. Yesterday we also established that the new man has a change of nature and that he has become a partaker of God's divine nature. We use 2 Peter and chapter 1 verse 4, 2 Peter and chapter 1 verse 4, that we have received his divine nature. 2 Peter chapter 1 and verse 4, he said, whereby are given unto us exceeding and great precious promises, that by these we, by these ye might be partakers of the divine nature, having escaped the corruption that is in the world through lust. So the point here is that we have escaped the corruption that is in the world. We are partakers. That means we share. We share in that his nature. We also, we do not only share, we administer his nature. So in that same nature, we can lay hands on the sick and the sick get healed. In the same nature, we can allow the nature of Christ gain the mastery of our body. Our body cannot play host to sickness and all of that stuff. It's time the believer wake up to the reality of what they know. Man is all about. The new man is not just a change in behavior. It's not behavior modification. Something has happened on our inside. Christ has taken up residence in us. His nature has become our nature. There is a change of nature. We have become partakers of his divine nature. And that is what the word of God says. We have become partakers of his divine nature. The trouble is the man in Christ sometimes believe that he can be outside of Christ and then back to Christ. And when we think this way, when we behave this way, then we live like men. And that is the challenge. We just believe today we are in Christ, and tomorrow when there is crisis, we are outside of Christ, because we always think that being saved or being a new man is all about our behavior modification. No, our nature has changed. And if our nature has changed, it affects every aspect of our life. So we have his divine nature. We are joint heirs with him. We are born of the word of God. So this new man is not all by himself. No, the Bible says that he did not just reconcile us, but he reconciled us to himself. The work of reconciliation was initiated by the Father, so that will be conformed in the image of his Son. Glory be to God forever. Child of God, you that is watching, I want you to understand that in times like this, the panic should be off, the fear should be off. What should be in our mind should be who we are in Christ. What has happened to us? We have escaped. There is a nature we have. We have his divine nature. There is a seed in us. It is called the incorruptible seed. That something has happened. We are born of his word. We are not born of the rumors. We are not born of the news. We are not born of everything flying around. We are born of the word. We know who we are, and we should stay in who we are. Glory be to God forever. We read a scripture yesterday, which is Galatians chapter 2 verse 20. That is the point of identification that quite a number of believers, they forget. He said, I am crucified with Christ. So Paul was saying, upon crucifixion, it happened for him. He said, nevertheless, I live, yet not I, but Christ liveth in me. He said, and the life which I now live in the flesh, I live. Take note of the word. The life I now live in the flesh, not in the spirit. The life I live in the flesh, not in the spirit. The life I live in the flesh, I live by the faith of the Son of God who loved me and gave himself for me. So the challenge is, people still believe I can be saved, but salvation just happened in my spirit. But what happened in your spirit can affect your body. What happens in your spirit can affect everything that has to do with you. Every fiber of your being can be affected by the work of the spirit. So the nature of God on your inside affects your body. And as a matter of fact, it dictates the direction of your body. I wonder, Paul said to the church in Corinth, he said, what? Know you not that your body is the temple? Your body is the temple. Now, not what is, so that life that you have affects your body also. So mortality can be swallowed of immortality. Your body can experience the best of God while on earth. Your body can live above the vicissitudes and the things that are putting others down. Your body can live of the virus that the world all over are scared of. God has not given to us the spirit of fear. We said yesterday, before Timothy was reminded of 2 Timothy chapter 2, chapter 1, verse 7, verse 6, explained something to Timothy. Maybe we'll just read it. 2 Timothy, he said, wherefore I put thee in remembrance that thou tear off the gift of God which is in thee by the putting up of my hands. And then the next verse said, for God had not given us the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of sound mind. So before Timothy was reminded of Paul, of this particular verse, he had to put him in remembrance. And that is what I'm doing today, to put you in remembrance of what is already in you. You know, sometimes we think that when things happen, God will start running helter-skelter. What do I do? What do I do? What do we do? What should we do? And how do we get over this? No. Everything it takes for you to live above the vicissitude of life has been put in you. It's embedded in you. It's in that nature, that divine nature of God in you, that nature that lives above the natural, is already in you. So all you need to put you in remembrance, to remind you of what is in there. A lot has been deposited inside of you. Yesterday we also used the same scripture in 1 Timothy and chapter number 4 verse 16. We have to mention this because Timothy had been reminded here. He said, take it unto thyself and unto the doctrine. Continue in them. And therefore, in doing this, thou shalt both save thyself and them that hear thee. Let's backtrack to verse 14. Let's read from verse 14 because we mentioned this yesterday. He said, neglect not the gift that is in thee, which was given thee by prophecy, with the laying on of the hands of the presbytery. Don't neglect it. So the challenge is, we neglect. Verse 15. The challenge is, we neglect it and meditate upon these things. So we need to meditate on what we have. And so Timothy, I don't know what Timothy was going through at this particular point in time, but Paul, his, you know, his father, if you please, or his pastor, his mentor, if you please, I have to remind him in this First Timothy, he said, don't neglect it. Stir it up. He said, meditate upon this thing. You don't need another power to overcome this present time. What is in you is enough to overcome this present. You don't need something extra. Child of God, I want you to understand, scientists are confused. The medical world, they are confused. The rich are confused. Even their money cannot save them. Men are scared. Men are afraid. Depression is taking the center stage. But in the midst of this, the Bible says we can shine as light because we are sons of light. We are children of light. In the midst of a perverse generation, crooked generation, we can shine. When men feel all hope is gone, that is when we remind them there is something on our inside. We have his divine nature. His divine nature overcomes everything natural. He said, meditate on these things. Give thyself wholly to them, that thy profiting may appear to us. I'd like for us to just pause for a moment and think about this. You know, it's also possible that Timothy lived a life that people could not see the evidence of the giftings of God in him. They didn't see the evidence of the life of God in him. They didn't see the evidence or the fruit of, you know, what he had received
scripture. And then overcomes Paul wrote to Timothy. I said, Timothy, this is the key. The key is what is in you, don't neglect. In times like this, I need to remind us, we are not just saved, and then we are hopeless in this world. We are not just saved without direction in this world. We are not just saved. And sometimes the way we pray, oh God, come. No. God put you there to change the situation. It is time to talk tough. It is time to speak boldly. Because when there are no challenges, you hear believers shout, the righteous is as bold as lion. In the midst of a little challenge, we soon forget who we are. We forget that we are bold people. You know, if you read the book of Acts of the Apostles in chapter 4, and the Bible says that the disciples, they were threatened. And the Bible says they went to their company. And when they had prayed, the place was shaking. And then the only prayer they said, he said, grant unto thy servant that with all boldness they will speak the word. And that you stretching forth your hands in the name of your only child, Jesus, that signs, wonders, and miracles be done in his name. When they were threatened, it was not time to, you know, go back in fear. They went to pray. And after